Today, I will give a demonstration on the mixing of zinc phosphate cement. And the reason that I'm going to do this with video is that it's much more clearly demonstrated with a video camera live than it would be from slides. And as you might know from your reading, the proper mixing of zinc phosphate cement is really critical in terms of the final properties of the material and that you gain the proper working time. The armamentarium that's needed are the bottles of zinc phosphate cement. This is the phosphoric acid liquid right here. And the powder is principally zinc oxide and some magnesium oxide, the minor amounts in the powder itself. In addition, you need your cement spatula, stainless steel cement spatula that you see here, and finally a cement mixing slab that has been cleaned and dried, and preferably one that has been refrigerated or put into a bath for a period of time. One has to be careful, however. I placed one in the freezer just to demonstrate if it's too cold, and I don't know if you can see that clearly. If it's too cold, you can see that moisture forms on the surface because of the dew point, and you can then see by wiping here that the moisture is removed. One has to wait until the glass slab arrives at a higher temperature so that moisture does not form, and then the mixing can begin. You can look up to see what the effect is of surface moisture on the setting of the zinc phosphate cement, but it will have an effect on the setting. Initially, no matter what one mixes where there's a powder, you should fluff the powder to some extent so that it's not too dense. The next step is to place two capfuls, and it's not really an entire capful, it's to the top of the dome where it becomes flat internally, and I'm sure on the white here it's a little hard with the contrast, but it's just to the top of the cap that will fill two levels of powder. As I'm doing now, I'm squeezing the powder and in the process, and it's a little hard to do it exactly because it doesn't lie flat, but you can get awfully close. And there's one capful, and then a second capful. Anytime you use either powders or liquids, remember to replace the cap after you've dispensed the material. The next step then is to create a flat surface so that you can divide it up into the proper increments. And this can then be divided into half, then into quarters. Not quite a quarter there. And this segment can be divided into an eighth and then 2/16. Okay.
All right.
Next, I'll dispense the liquid. And in dispensing the liquid, you hold the bottle vertically and gently squeeze, and you'll see the droplets forming. And you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12, and remember once again to replace the cap when you're using the liquids, because if water is lost here, it'll alter the setting characteristics of the material, of the phosphoric acid and the zinc phosphate mix. Okay, our next step then is to begin mixing. And you'll want to review the times of mixing. And one handy thing to start with is using a stopwatch to begin with, because you'll note that there are 15 second intervals of mixing, and then it goes to 20 seconds and finally 35 seconds. So I'll use for my purposes here right now the stopwatch just to keep track. The first part is you take in one of the 16th elements and you dispense it over a wide area, or mix it over a very wide area, to dissipate the heat of the reaction, and then the objective is to thoroughly mix in the zinc phosphate zinc oxide powder. And then after 15 seconds you take in one more 16th, and you'll notice I'm using kind of a stropping motion over a wide area, thoroughly incorporating the powder. And now at the end of 30 seconds I incorporate the 1/8 segment. 30 for 15 seconds. And then a 1/4 segment for 20 seconds. And then another 1/4. You'll notice I take a little care with the initial entry of the powder into the liquid. It wouldn't take much with either some air or to blow a portion of it away from the glass slab. And this is for 20 seconds again. And then the final increment is incorporated. Sometimes the ratios are not exactly perfect and you may need to add a little powder on the slab if the viscosity does not turn out to be just quite right. Okay, now it is the complete 2 minutes, and as proof of that I'll have Bill zoom in on the watch right there. And what you do at this stage then is that you gather the cement together, and then you test its viscosity, and it should string about 2 centimeters. It comes up just a slight bit short, and what one can do then is add a tiny bit of powder over in the corner here and incorporate that. You can take a small amount of powder, and that should render the proper viscosity for a 1 to 2 centimeter mix, about like so. That is pretty much ideal. And I'll hold this to the side again so that you can see as I lift it. Okay, that pretty much completes just the mixing technique for zinc phosphate cement. One thing that's important too is the proper cleanup, and you can note the syllabus instructions for that. One thing you do want to do after the crown has been loaded and you proceed with cementation, then place the cement slab along with the mixing instruments in water, and typically will clean up nicely in water.